सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। मंत्र कामस्याप्तिं जगतः प्रतिष्ठां क्रतोरनन्त्यम् अभयस्य पारम् स्तोमं महदुरुगायं प्रतिष्ठां दृष्ट्वा धृत्या धीरो नचिकेतोऽत्यस्राक्षी नचिकेतोऽत्यस्राक्षी तं दुर्दर्शं गूढमनुप्रविष्टम् गुहाहितं गव्वरेष्ठं पुराणम् अध्यात्मयोगादिगमेन देवं मत्वा धीरो हर्षशोकौ जहाति तं दुर्दर्शं गूढमनुप्रविष्टम् गुहाहितं गव्वरिष्ठं पुराणम् अध्यात्मयोगादिगमेन देवं मत्वा धीरो हर्षशोकौ जहाति धीरो हर्षशोकौ चहाति। ट्वेल्थ एंड थर्टींथ वर्स इज द ज्ञान साधनम। सो इन दिस वर्स ट्वेल्थ वर्स विद्या स्तुति इज देयर एंड विद्या फल स्तुति इज देयर। सो and what is the way to attain the vidya? Three things are there. What are three things? Vidya stuti, vidya sadhanam, and vidya phalistuti. Praise of the knowledge, praise of the means of knowledge, and praise of the fruit of knowledge. Okay. So tam durdarsham. Tam durdarsham means what? What was the word I gave for Durdarshan? What is the meaning? Durdarsham? Without seeing, you have to say that. When you come in the class, just go through it. So you can know. So we have to define the word. Durdarsham, you can't say something. It is only specific meaning. Vedanta is very tight in its explanation. So tam Durdarsham. And when I am talking, you avoid reading the book. Some of you read the commentary. So you can read before or after, because mind is not meant for two at a time. Okay. So Durdarsham, otherwise I'll give you total Sanskrit one. So when we used to give in the course, we gave the total Sanskrit, so they could not read. So they had no choice but to look at me. But when you know, then you start looking here and there. So, Durdarsha means Indriya Gochar, which is difficult to be perceived because of our habit. I'm quickly going. Gudham means it is there, but because not noticeable, because our attention is not there. Anupravishtam means going through all. Anupravishtam means going through all. Guhahitam means which is the sakshi or the seer of our absence of presence of thought. Seated in the cave. Guha means cave. Why buddhi is called cave? Here buddhi's intellect is called cave. Why? Two things are there. I think this I had not told. Two things. One is in cave there is a darkness. And second is cave is after going through a passage. So intellect, there is a darkness of tamogun. That is, we don't know. Therefore, intellect is called guha, cave. And secondly, we have to cross the, you have five koshas were there. Morning you heard. Five sheets I had mentioned. Anybody can say? Five sheets. Annamay. Second. Pranamay. Okay, united we stand. So, together, one person will say Annamay. I think you all will know it. So, it is covered by that. Because I see you and not your buddhi directly. When I see your body only. I don't see your intellect. Okay. Maybe I can hear your speech. So, how, which is closer to me, your body or your speech? To me, not to you. Outer person, body is closer than the speech. After speaking, I can know your pranamaya kosh. Then after living with you for some time, I will know your manomaya kosh, what is your mind. Outside this person was looking not good, but his mind is very nice. Sometimes outside we see somebody. I met somebody, very clumsy person. Very clumsy person, not very greatly mannered person. But when I lived with him, I said, iska to his manoma is very nice. So, but which is easily, that means that these things are covering it up. The annamay, pranamay, manomay, then you will know the vijnanamay. So therefore, don't give opinion about anybody so easily. In life, we have to be very careful. Please don't become a judge very fast. No need to conclude about that person. Well, he is very good. Wait. Live with him. Wait. It is a hasty conclusion. It's not good. Live with him. You will know the person in due time. It will take time. So, annamay, pranamay, manomay, then was vijnanamay. This vijnanamay is the buddhi. Where your, when I say Hari Om, so this Hari Om knowledge is taking place here. I say this is watch, so this knowledge is taking place in the vijnanamay. Not in the body. Only my body watch knows. Body does not know. Body is inert. So what this is called watch? Child is also knowing it, but child doesn't know this is called watch. But in the vijnanamay, this is called watch. All your convictions are there. Therefore, it is called cave. Two reasons. One was because there is a darkness there, because we don't know the self. Second reason, because 3-4 layers are there. And supposing you are caught up in the outer layer, then you won't go inside. You are very hungry. At that time, somebody says, what? Tell me about the gist of summary of the first valley. With summary? First valley, summary you gave. First to 29. I'm so hungry. I'm so hungry. First, let me have food. Last night also did not eat. So outer koshas cover the inner koshas. And because the cave is not directly known, therefore it is called cave. But in that case, there is one witness. And therefore he is called Guha Hitam. This is all the name of Atma. Those who are Sanskrit student, please see matva is a verb here. And the object of this verb is all these. Tam, durdarsham, gudam, anupravishtam. These are all in which case? Accusative case. So when you talk to somebody, I'm talking to you. I'm talking to Ravin. So Ravin has to be an accusative case. And I have to be a nominative case. So where accusative case is there, then most of the time, is there. Ramam. Ravindram. Ramam. Therefore, all are in dots. Are you seeing that? Tam durdarsham gudham anupravishtam guhahitam gavarishtam puranam. Okay. And what is the verb here? Matva. So one who knows this Atma. Gavarishtam also I told. Just I want to tempt you with Sanskrit. I want to tempt you. I want to know this. I want to know it very fast. So lovely, I didn't know that. Okay. So one who knows Gavarishtam also I told. This word I had yet to take. Adhyatma Yogadi Gamena. This is an instrumental case. By the knowledge of the Adhyatma. What is the meaning of knowledge of that? Fixing the mind in the Atma. Fixing the mind in the Atma. Very beautiful point is there. It is not my habit to rush fast. What to do? Those who have commentaries, please see the first line of this commentary. Is it page 54 in your book? No, after next page you open, 54. This commentary, I think I must have made you underline. Adhyatma Yogadi Gamena Vishayebhya Prati Samritya Chetasa Atmani Samadhanam Adhyatma Yoga. Underline, you know? This is how mission studies are there. In that book, it is not there. You won't get that. This I am talking of. This is a commentary. What does it mean? Taking the mind away from sense objects and fixing in the self. How? Please tell me, explain in detail, please. Please explain in detail. Okay, I'm explaining. Why don't I hurry? Oh, no, I'm not hurrying. Okay, so supposing you are sitting quietly and in your mind comes, I have to go to purchase vegetable. Then you withdraw no vegetable. I don't have to purchase. Then you feel, I am this person here. My work is there. Slowly you are trying to withdraw the mind. How do you withdraw? How do you withdraw? Withdrawing by devaluating where the mind is going. Withdrawal means devaluation. Devaluation. Let's ask him. Do it later on. Devaluation. Only by standing only he stopped. What is still you tell? So devaluation. Withdrawal means what? I am not that. There is. I don't want. Let this thing be for the person. I have nothing to do with any object, any person for 5 minutes. 5 minutes, cut your relation from everybody. Please note, including your own body. Including in the last night's class, I was telling one line that please keep your life at a distance. If you remember. Remember that. So when you start doing meditation or you are start thinking, don't mix your life into it. Use this person objectively. This person was there, he got up in the morning, he went there, he was very happy, he was sad, he was angry. Who? This person. Who wants that? Who dislikes this person? Who? This person. With whom I am living day and night. Acha? From this person, I try to slowly withdraw. And where you are focusing? I'm focusing on the same sakshi. And how do you withdraw? You withdraw from somebody. How? Where you strip the importance. If you don't strip the importance, it will remain in your mind. This is called Adhyatma Adiyog. A very beautiful word is there. So what are you doing? I'm lying. Like your mind is very involved with somebody. I'm giving you another way to think. I'm thinking a lot about somebody. Please don't fight with the mind and don't get sad. My mind is going so much, I don't know what my mind is. I'm so bad. I never thought I'm so bad also. Only coming in the mission, I realized I'm so bad. Sure, yes. Before that, I never thought I thought I was very good. Don't fight with the mind. Mind is Bali. Anybody who fights with the mind, you know the story of Bali. Anybody who fought with Bali, Bali took half his strength. So it was impossible to defeat him. Then what shall I do? Please take out the value. I don't have any value for that. For what? For that person. Well, I don't like. But this is, you have given a value now. By not liking, you have given a value. By liking, you have given a value. It's fine. I don't care for it. Then what to do that? What to do after that? Automatically, mind leaves that person's thought. Leaves means, not leaves means thought will go away. Thought will be there, but you will not be attached to the thought. To have a thought is one thing, and to be attached to the thought is another thing. In my mind, thought came, let us have ice cream. Supposing, in my mind doesn't come, don't worry. My mind, these thoughts don't come. Then, thought came but I didn't identify. It's okay, this is not the time. This is class going on. You are reading Kathopanishad or ice cream? You didn't know Shuva Bhava Amartya Siddhanta Kaitat Sarvendriyanam Jaryanti Teja Yarina. Like a child is there, he is making some kind of mischief and mother is just not giving any intonation. He said, Mummy, Mummy. Mummy is just sitting. Mummy. If Mummy has to show that she is not interested, she won't talk. Mummy. You are not showing anger, but showing disinterest. So show disinterest to the mental running around. Disinterest. I hope you are getting my point. This is called Adhyatma Yogadi Gamena Devam. So Matva Dhiraha. Dhira means who is ready to withdraw and evaluate. It is all at an intellectual level. He is a dhira at an intellectual level. That means he is devaluating it intellectually. Don't physically say to anybody, you have no value. No, it's not that. Don't do such thing, foolish things. You go to your father, mother and say, you have no value. They will hit you. Bully, this is what you learnt. I will make your program now. You went to SUP. Let me see how I turned you. Don't do all these funny things. So dhira means you don't know, all kinds of cases come to me. Somebody was introducing the wife. Bully, Swamiji, this five element is my wife. Is this the way to talk? This is the way to talk. I said, then who are you then? You are also five element. Don't use unnecessarily. Don't talk Vedanta while in your regular life. Okay, it should not be a funny thing. You talk in the language of devotion, love, compassion. Vedanta should not be talked on regular basis. It is a very serious matter. I feel Vedanta is a very serious matter. Anyway, so Adhyatma Yogadi Gamema Devam. Devam is same Atma, Dhiraha, who is constantly trying to withdraw from wrong notions. हर्ष शोकौ जहाति, ही लीव्स द एक्साइटमेंट एंड ग्रीफ. व्हाट इज ग्रीफ? समथिंग इज लॉस्ट. आई फील आई हैव लॉस्ट एवरीथिंग. ग्रीफ, अंडरस्टैंड? नो, समथिंग इज लॉस्ट, देयर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ गेटिंग इट. आई अटैच माई आइडेंटिटी एंड आई फील आई हैव बिकम वेरी स्मॉल बिकॉज ऑफ दैट. हम कुछ रहे नहीं है. Somebody dies sometime and then the father says, mother says, for whom to live? As if there is no God, there is no Lakshya, there is no Moksha Purusha, there is no Guru, there is nothing. When he passed away, Manlo, child has passed, very unfortunate incident that somebody has passed away. I also have sympathy. But after that, what they say, then it is not right. For whom to live, Swamiji? Live for me also. God is there. Scriptures are there. Khatam hogi tumhari duniya kya? Whole world is over or what? As if no world is there. Everything is gone. This is called shok. You feel I've lost everything. Never allow these emotions to overpower. It may will come. It will come. But never be allowing it to totally drown you in it. This is totally anti-scriptural life. Spiritual person is very cheerful person. And what is harsh? I'll tell you what is harsh. Harsh means something you get, you find I got everything. Something these boys and girls talk. Very interesting. I'll tell you what they say. Boy met the girl, and that girl after meeting he says, when you come, I got whole world. जब तुम आती हो ऐसा लगता है पूरा जहां आ गया, पूरी दुनिया आ गई. ये तारे, ये सूरज, ये चंद्रमा, सब कुछ हमारे हृदय में, हमारे दिल में समा गए. बस तुम आती हो तो when you come, I feel I got everything. Stars, moon, sun, everything has come. Not they are not in the and they are not in the space, they are not in the sky, they are just in front of you, your eyes, your smile, the stars shine on your teeth, the sun shines in your eyes, everything is I got everything. Later on she will take everything. Just wait. All lokas will go away except narak lok. all the lokas which you are seeing in the eyes, in the hair, in the teeth, you know, everything will go away. Ye isko bolte harsh. And a person is very excited. Oh, they dance like this, they do like this. You know, these youngsters. One of my friends were there. I think I was in graduation. Very good in mathematics. I'm not telling his name, everything is recorded. You don't know where they are. So he got 99 out of 100. He jumped in the air. His hand went inside this fan. Fan was moving. And his nature was to get excited. Sometimes you have to solve the problem, difficult problem, because he was very good in mathematics. So he was used to dance after that. I see, you don't dance. Because problem is solved is very good. You are very good, but don't dance all this. Don't be overexcited. And supposing he could not solve the problem, is to hit his head like that. Taking the hand, so bad. This kind of moody people, whimsical kind of people, unbalanced personality, is very dangerous. Because all of a sudden he'll jump, all of a sudden he'll fall down. What is all this nonsense? Already he was tall and he put his hand like that. Anyway, so harsh shoka jahati. I was not concerned about the hand. I was concerned the fan may not break. So, So when the person knows the self, he leaves the grief. Ho gaya, dukh ho gaya, he went away. Yes, I was sad today. I was sad, yes, I was sad. Agya, it emotion. Although sadness emotion is very much disrespected in Gita. Highly disrespected in Bhagavad Gita, in Mahabharat, in Upanishads. Some emotions are very much disrespected in, like anger emotion, sadness emotion, attachment, all these things are, they will be saying that you are foolish person of the highest order if there is nobody foolish like you. Nanu Shuchanti Pandita. Itni ninda, so much they condemn, bole, what is there to be said? And some people have thought fixation. Harsha Shokav, he leaves it. Who? One who knows that. With the six things. I'm not asking you six things. Then the student went Nachiketa. He said, Gurudev, please explain Adhyatma Yoga Adhigam again. Now, this is the 13th mantra. Is explanation of Adhyatma Yoga Adhigamen. Please repeat. एतत् श्रुत्वा संपरिग्रह्य मर्त्यः Shall I break it? एतत् श्रुत्वा संपरिग्रह्य मर्त्यः प्रव्रह्य धर्मम् अणुमेतमाप्य समोदते मोदनीयगम हि लब्ध्वा विव्रतगम सद्म नचिकेतसं मन्ये अगेन एतत् श्रुत्वा संपरिगृह्य मर्त्यः प्रव्रीय धर्मम् अणुमेतमाप्य स मोदते मोदनीयगम हि लब्ध्वा विव्रतगम सद्म नचिकेतसं मन्ये See here it is said here. एतत् श्रुत्वा Having heard this. Therefore Vedanta is a topic of hearing. Not reading. It's a topic of hearing. Having heard, what having heard? Last, that this is the nature of the Atma. Having heard this, what he does after heard? How he hears? How he hears? Here it is in Acharya Prasadat. Not by Guru. Not by Guru. Then, by the grace of Guru. That sounds good. Because unless Guru talks with lot of compassion and grace, he will not bring his best. So, this is why I like this. Acharya Prasadat. So, he is bahut khush hoke koi. Somebody is speaking with lot of joy, lot of grace, as if grace is coming out as the teaching, as the words. Not that Acharya thinks, how long I have to teach, I don't know. I'm so bored by teaching. Same student, same such, same me. Acharya Prasadat, he should have lot of love, lot of grace, the student. Okay, he should not be tired of explaining. When I explained it yesterday, again he is asking the same question. He doesn't do homework, keeps on asking this question. So, Acharya Prasadat. some people don't do homework. Anyway, Acharya Prasadat. What is it? Samparigrihya. Samparigrihya means clearly grasping. Samparigrihya means clearly grasping. Martya, the seeker. Martya means seeker. The person who is seeking. Pravriya. Pravriya means extracting. Extracting, like you extract the juice out of the out of the fruit. Orange juice is there, or apple juice is there. You extract out of. Similarly, what shall I extract? Extract Atma out of that whole body. Bole Atma out of the body. Which grinder is there? If I die, what will I do with the Atma? Atma aa bhi jaye to kya hai? Mar jayenge. At least I am alive without extracting. Don't put me in extractor. At least I am alive, living, at least laughing, talking. If I put my body and I die, who will know Vedanta after that? Atma to chali jayegi, hum akele reh jayenge. Dekho, don't use unnecessary logic. Here extracted is an intellectual process, not a physical process. That means intellectually you think that these five koshas, I'll explain more, you just get introduction. They are not mine, not mine, not mine. So extraction means what? You are disidentifying. Disidentify, you understand, no? No? Disidentify. I know that. Disidentify means what? Somewhere I was thinking this is mine. Supposing somebody steals the watch. So you will not have sorrow. Why? Because it is not your watch. You are not identified with that watch. Identifies means what? Tadatadatmya. Tasmin atman atmani buddhi. Tasmin atma buddhi. Like mother is identified with the son. Son is having fever. Mother is also down that day. Kya ho gaya? Fever ho gaya. My daughter has son has fever. I'm so sad, Swami. What happened to you? My son has fever today. Are the fever, you take Panado and some medicine and she will be fine. Good, he is quiet for a day. So, I'm so sad. What happened? Are fever again? My Lallu has fever. Are let him rest for one day. If I have fever, you have no problem. You don't say anything. You say like that. Swamiji has fever, I am very sad. You are happy that there is no class. On the other hand. Fever, वहाँ पे तुमको परेशानी हो रही है. Tadat means what is not yours, you are claiming it. What is not yours, claiming what is not yours, claiming a wrong thing with which you have no relation, you are claiming it. Like the thief does. Thief, you know, one thief was there, right? He stole some goods from somebody's house. One thief stole goods from somebody's house. We were going on the way in the night. Now another thief came, second thief. He grabbed from this first one and ran away. Now the first thief is shouting, thief, thief. Now which is the real thief? First one or second one? I think first one is more, because when you yourself are a thief, you cannot say other is a thief. He's a double thief actually. So what is the meaning of prabhriya? Disclaiming. Disclaiming. You know, outside our gate there is a disclaimer is written. Disclaimer. In your, you know, that was given to you guidelines, it was written that if you lose your purse or you lose your money or lose your ornaments, ashram won't be responsible. Don't say, please give me 50,000 Chinmay Mission. Why? I lost my ring. Don't say, it's your responsibility. You have come to do the course or be with the ring. Anyway, so disclaimer. So what is this? I'm disclaiming. Pravriya. Dharmyam. Dharmyam. What is the meaning of dharmyam? Very careful. Dharmyam here is dharmya is the name of the Atma. Dharma is the name of the Atma. because of two reasons. What are the two reasons? Because Atma can be attained only by doing dharma. Unless you do the right thing, you won't have a quiet mind. You won't be the free from your interaction. Supposing you told the truth, so after that you don't have to be buried. I said, I did something wrong, then that wrong thought will not leave you so easily. I did not do anything wrong, so I'm fine. I spoke the right thing. I'm very clear about that. In my life is very clear. More you do dharma, more you have to be fearful about something, somebody. Right? I'm doing the right thing. I never stole, I never lied, I never had wrong relation with anybody, I never cheated anybody, so I'm fine. It's fine. Now I'm ready, I can sit now. Why? Because there is no thought which is bogging me and troubling me. I didn't say anything, but I fought with you. And after that I'm sitting for Vedanta class. Right? Your pen will be here, but you will think about that person. And I can make it out from here. How he's listening, he'll do like that. I can make that his mind is in some adharma he did mentally, and he's occupied by that mind. He is not a free-minded person like that. Hey, huh? How are you? Who? I'm talking to you, I don't talk to ghost, okay? You are the only one sitting here. How are you? Why? I'm just asking, how are you? Courtesy, I'm asking, how are you? I don't need any courtesies. I want to keep to myself. Enough, I have seen everybody. Whomever I trusted, they left me. I don't like anybody here. I don't know where to run away also. Now, where you want to go? I think I will go to Himalayas one day. Why don't you go? Mobile doesn't work. Free. And if you do any mistake, if the person says, sorry, it's my mistake, please forgive me. And not that, I have made a mistake, I'll pay for it. I will pay for my mistake, I'll do repentance for that. This is my mistake. Are you getting my point? Dharmya, this is one meaning of dharmya. Second meaning, Atma itself is called dharmya. Why? Because it holds, it's a holder. Remember, somewhere also it had, dharma word had come for holder. Somewhere in some mantra it was there. Well, please don't ask me. Somewhere it had come. Anyway, let me see who can tell. Not now, later on you go through the first valley and search where is it. Always a good student is the one. When he sees a word, his mind antenna starts thinking, where it has come? Let me see. Be a very good student, not a good student, very good student. It is a serious matter. For me, every word is a very serious matter. Dharmya, because it is the holder. So, how will you say in Sanskrit? Students can do. Karma yog rup pravritti dharmasya and jnana yog rup nivritti dharmasya. Dharak. Karma yoga group, when it is holding the actions and then you reach the portals of Vedanta. Another is, it is of the nature. Gyan yoga group, nivritti dharmasya dharaka. So this is Atma is the holder. Therefore here Atma name is dharmya. Okay. Anum. Anum means which has less property, no property. Apya. Apya means having need. So having heard this, he starts thinking and he knows that I am this self. Then what happens to him? समोदते,
मोदते मींस
ही रिजॉइसेस. व्हाई? मोदनीय गम ही लब्ध्वा, बिकॉज ही हैज गॉट द मोस्ट हैप्पीएस्ट. देन ही डज नॉट से आई एम हैप्पी, ही सेज आई एम हैप्पीनेस. He does not see, because happy is a verb and happiness is I am happiness. Any verb involves a movement. Any verbs involves a movement. You got my point? Like I'm walking, talking. So happy is also movement. So sa modate modaniya gam hi labdhva. Modini, most blissful, most joyful. Okay.